Welcome to a new segment of Front Row hosted by Economy.lk. And today we are in conversation with Ms. Shivani Hegde, MD and CEO of Nestlé Lanka. Shivani, Nestlé is of course a world famous conglomerate that has been operating in Sri Lanka for quite a while and quite successfully as well. Contrastingly, there are other MNCs that have kind of looked at the Sri Lankan economy and have not seen the sort of potential and the successes that Nestlé has. What has Nestlé uniquely identified as opportunities or ways of operating in Sri Lanka in the kind of the current status?
Well, if I look at what has been happening in some of the other developed countries as well as in emerging markets, I think I would like to talk about two specific areas. And the first is in the context of the agronomic sector, the agricultural sector, because in countries like Sri Lanka, still 80% of our population is living in rural areas. And while agriculture is providing employment to a lot of people, it's still generating only about 8% of the GDP of the country. And what is absolutely critical, therefore, is to build thriving and resilient rural communities, communities of people who have a sustainable source of income. They are not impacted by the vagaries of weather conditions, and how they can have alternate sources of income as well. And I think how this can drive the growth of the economy in particular is firstly by contributing towards import substitution, by providing alternate crops, by providing ways in which we can reduce the import bill, and at the same time also helping us to identify opportunities for export. Now, what is Nestlé doing about this? I think very clearly, as far as we are concerned, we have, since the time we started operations in Sri Lanka, which is actually 112 years ago, we have been working with rural communities. And about 30 years ago, when we started our efforts for development of the dairy sector, and that was a point of time when the quantity and the quality of milk available in the country was insufficient. So Nestlé has been working very closely with the farmers, with the farming community, providing them with technology assistance, providing them with microfinancing facilities, infrastructure, but also a route to market through our collection centers and our milk districts. And this has helped us to develop an ecosystem of 20,000 farmers who are having a more sustainable form of income.
So in terms of creating that standard increase, the quality assurances and so on in the Sri Lankan market, do you feel that that knowledge that comes as a MNC, a multinational corporation, or having had this experience elsewhere, has helped in terms of establishing yourself in Sri Lanka? And is that something that a Sri Lankan unique domestic company would not necessarily have?
Well, I would say that it's certainly the model that we follow in all markets. I think our approach as being a multinational is actually to be a local multinational. And what we would like to do is to largely produce products locally and using local ingredients, and ensure that we are contributing towards the society in which we operate, are contributing towards the communities in which we operate. So our milk collection model is something that is not unique only to Sri Lanka. Nestlé has been doing this work in many other markets around the world where dairy is an important part of the
So speaking of community, one of the big factors and big obstacles for economic growth in Sri Lanka is low female labour force participation. And that community aspect of it also plays, because the socio-economic kind of ethos of the country tends to have an impact on that. How has Nestlé kind of circumvented these sort of obstacles? And what is Nestlé uniquely doing kind of to get more female participation in that production process?
Well, Nestlé has always believed in empowering women and bringing in more gender equality in the workplace. And we have been initiating a number of programs under the banner of Nestlé Needs Youth. Right? And we have launched this program here in Sri Lanka as well, where we are working with university students, we are working with graduates, we're working in rural economies as well, to try and encourage female participation in the workforce. Now, as you said rightly, it's a function of the socioeconomic ethos of the country, the traditional way in which roles and responsibilities have been defined at home, the need for the woman to take care of the child, issues on safety, etc. And I think what we would like to do as an organization is to help in that process. So just as an example, we have introduced flexible working arrangements for our women. We are encouraging hiring of women and also proper career planning for them, providing them opportunities for working in different environments, for expatriation wherever possible. And through these various initiatives, we are encouraging more women to be part of our network. Today, I'm very happy to share that amongst our senior management, we have 20% who are women. And if you look at actually the core management team, it is almost 40%.
That's brilliant. I mean, if I may extend that just a little bit more, I mean, you're one of maybe a handful of female CEOs in the kind of Sri Lankan economic kind of corporate world. What is it like operating in a mostly male-dominated corporate world, and what kind of unique challenges have you faced, and what have you done to overcome those sort of things?
Well, honestly, I don't think that there is anything different about the working culture here in Sri Lanka or in any other part of the world. And I have personally not faced any specific challenges in my role as a female business head. In fact, I started my career in Nestle as the first female sales representative for Nestle in that market. And that taught me that through my career to never wear a gender hat. So it's very important for women to be able to work in the environment and to understand what are the barriers that are perhaps holding them back, and to be able to overcome those barriers as well. As I mentioned, it's about supporting them in the socioeconomic transition, but also at the same time, we are undertaking programs with our male employees to remove any biases and encouraging our female employees to take the seat that they deserve, to sit at the table, to ask for what they really want, not to be afraid to move ahead.
And on that positive note, thank you very much, Shivani. And thank you very much. Join us again for a new segment of Front Row, hosted by Economy.lk soon. Thank you.